Hallelujah. Come on, let's bless the Lord. Let's create.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Come on and give him some glory.
Well-doing.
You can't get weary in your well-doing. Listen, I'm prophesying that there was a spirit of distraction. distraction that has been loose in the atmosphere, trying to destroy the people of God, trying to get them off track, trying to get them unfocused, trying to get them out of position. Come on, somebody, there is a spirit of distraction that is hoovering, and God is saying that this spirit will use anybody, is using anything, is using a situation to distract you from what God has called you to. He said, be not deceived in this season. He said, you got to see past the spirit of a man. See past it. See past the soul. See past the natural. He said, you need to see what the spirit is behind the man. Because some people are sent on assignment in this season to distract you. Some people are sent on assignment in this season to discombobulate you. Some people are sent on assignment in this season to frustrate you. And guess what? It's the very ones that's closest to you. It's your friend. It's your girl from around the way. Making you say, guess what God told you. Making you say, guess where God is positioning you. Come on, somebody. See, we think it can be something that we don't really know, but see, the enemy will use the closest people to us to get us off course.
Yes, yes.
May your eyes be open to see, your ears be open to hear, in the name of Jesus, in this season, time, and hour. For God is saying, I'm putting a power within you like never before to go forth and do my will. But the enemy is strategically sent to get you out of place, to get you out of order, and to get you out of his will. Are y'all hearing me today? See, we're going to talk about some stuff today. We're talking about women getting in alignment. And I was thinking about alignment. What does that mean? And God began to really talk to me about when your car is out of alignment. When your car needs an alignment. How do you know that your car needs an alignment? Because things start shaking. Things start getting a little, something ain't right. Something don't feel right. I ain't moving right. I'm not in position. You begin to go and seek somebody that can help you get in a position. Come on, somebody. He said, and when you know you're out of alignment, he said, you ain't stupid. You know something ain't right. You know something ain't right. And a lot of us will ride in that car until the wheels about to fall off, and you're like, okay, now I gotta go see somebody. Somebody gotta take care of this situation, because I know it's been out of alignment for a long time. I just held off for as long as I could. God said it's time for some of us to go and get your car back in alignment with his will. Get your car back in alignment with where he's taking you. Get your car back in alignment, because you know it's been out of line for a long time. God said, open up your ears to hear what I'm saying in this hour. Open up your ears to hear what I'm saying in this season. Things are out of alignment. He said, I'm repositioning you in this season. I'm getting you back focused. I'm getting you back to where I called you to. Alignment means proper adjustment. Alignment means that you done came into a state of agreement, not with your will, but with God's will. Come on, somebody. Because sometimes God's will don't feel good. It don't feel good to you. But God said, I need you to get in alignment with my will. I need you to come in agreement with my will. Stop letting these spirits distract you. Stop letting these demons distract you. Stop letting situations distract you. Because it gets you out of alignment to where God is taking you. Because God said, all along, the power was within you to get yourself together. See, listen. The power is always within us to make a move in the right direction. It's just that we don't move. It's just that we don't do. It's just that we don't walk in the obedience that God called us to. God said, it's time for you to bust a move and get in alignment to what I'm doing. It might not look good. It might not feel good. He said, but the power is within you to control your flesh. Come on, somebody. Your flesh is your soul, your mind, your will, your intellect. He said, yeah, get it under submission to your spirit. Your flesh is a horrible master. But it's an awesome servant. I'm going to say that again. Your flesh is a horrible master, but it's an awesome servant. If you tell it to do what you want to do, baby, ain't nothing going to stop your next level. Ain't nothing going to hinder you from doing what God told you to do. Because you called your flesh into submission to your spirit. The power is within you. The power is within you. I came to talk to you about a tale of two Eves. So if you're taking notes, we're going to talk about two Eves today. We're going to talk about the power being within them the whole time. When we talk about power, I lift this up to Pat. It says power is the ability to do or the ability to act. The capability of accomplishing something or the possession or the authority. And then God gave me this. He said, you got the power to love or you got the power to hate. You got the power to be bitter or you got the power to forgive. You got the power to start an argument or you got the power to control your mind. Come on, somebody. He said, you got the power to act a fool or you got the power to submit to the word of God. What are you going to do? He said, you got the power to be broken or to be better. What will you do in this season, time, and hour? Because God said the power is within you to get in alignment to my will. But are you willing, ready, and able to do it?
Yes.
We're talking about alignment, women coming in kingdom alignment and doing what God told you to do. But if you're not walking in the power and the authority that God told you, then you're going to miss God in this season. I'm going to say it again. You're going to miss God in this season. You got the power to be at war with yourself. Or with somebody else, and you got the power to be at peace. Which one will you choose? You got the power to keep bringing up stuff that happened 10 years ago, or you got the power to move up? You got the power to keep it moving Susan. Because as long as you let that demon called memory recall hindering you from getting to your next level, you're going to stay stuck on stupid. Come on, somebody. And God is saying, no, we still living in 10 years ago. We still in yesteryear. What about right now? Where we at right now? It's the power of two Eves. We're talking about two Eves. We're talking about two mothers, two women of power, two women chosen by God, yet two women with issues. Two women with struggles, but yet two women with favor. Who are the two Eves? We got Eve and we got Mary. Those are the two Eves that we're talking about today. It's the tale of two Eves. Y'all flow with me because we're going somewhere. Now see, the first Eve cooperated in the fall of man. But the second Eve cooperated in the deliverance of man.
Yes.
The first Eve cooperated in the sin of man. But the second Eve cooperated in the healing and the breakthrough of man.
Yes.
See, y'all got to flow with me. There is the tale of two Eves. It's like one versus the other. One doing one thing, the other doing the other thing. The first Eve operated in doubt.
Yes.
But the second Eve operated in faith.
Yes.
What had everything to do with the fall of man, but the other had everything to do with the come up of man. It's a tale of two Eves. Both of them had the power within them to do exactly what God told them to do. But one failed and the other got herself together so she could break through to her breakthrough. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
The tale of two Eves. So I look at this and I'm like, okay, we got the power within. We got Eve and we got Eve, but we got really it's Eve and we got Mary because both of them were the beginning of something. So Eve walked and sat there and I said, listen to this. You want to talk about two of the most powerful women in the Bible. You got to bring up Eve and you got to bring up Mary. Why? Because Eve was so powerful. She was so anointed. I say that because she was one that God walked with in the cool of the day. Like, what's up, Eve? What are we doing today? What's going on? What you got going on? What's popping? He was one that walked with Eve in the cool of the day. But when Mary, he was one that had to dwell on the inside of her. She had to become impregnated with him. She was one of, they were the two of the closest women to God ever mentioned in the Bible because one walked with him and one became impregnated with him. One birthed greatness out of him and one walked with greatness. Come on, somebody. One of them walked with greatness and one of them birthed greatness. Two women, the most powerful women in the Bible. Are you walking with greatness every single day? Or are you birthing him out? Which one are you doing? Are you doing both in this season, time, and hour? Because the power is within you to walk with him. The power is within you to talk with him. The power is within you to birth something great out of your bosom. Oh, come on, somebody. What are you doing? It's the tale of two Eves, the two most powerful women who were in alignment. They were in alignment with God. They were in alignment with God. And we have to look at this. One of the things that God did, and I love this, is when he dealt with Eve. She was in the garden.
Yes.
And she was given a challenge. And the challenge is, Eve, all of this stuff is yours. You got favor from me, Eve. I just need you to do one thing. Not eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
Yes.
Okay, so she got that, right? Eve knew the word. She was able to recite it back to the enemy. But what she didn't know was she couldn't handle the whisper of spirits in her ear. Eve, is it really God that told you that? Eve, are you sure this is that direction that God told you? Eve, you know, really, Eve, do you really know that you know that you know? Eve could not handle the whispering spirits in her ear. She could recite the word. She could tell the devil what the word of the Lord said. Well, the Lord said that we can't. Well, the word of the Lord says that this. The word of the Lord says this. But then when it began to seduce her, it began to whisper sweet nothings in her ear. She didn't have a boy bot in her spirit. She began to contemplate. She began to debate on everything that the devil was whispering.
Yes.
But wait, the power was within her. She knew the word.
Yes.
She could recite the word back to the devil. But when that demon started whispering sweet nothings, it was something that made her shake in her knees. It was something that made her quiver. It was something that made her second guess everything that God told her. It was something that made her abort the promise and the plan of God. All because she couldn't handle a whispering demon in her ear. Oh, Jesus, I know what you're saying. I know it's soon to come, but God, I keep hearing this and I keep seeing this. And God, I didn't know that I couldn't handle the temptation.
Yes, Lord.
I didn't know that even though I got the word, I'm insecure. Even though I got the word, I still got issues in my tissue that I really don't know how to handle. Even though I got the word, oh God, it's contradicting my position. It's contradicting my prosperity. It's contradicting my destiny and my breakthrough. But I know I got the word, but Eve got the word, but she didn't know herself in the midst of it. She didn't know herself well enough to say, I can't handle this. I can't handle this. I need somebody else in my ear, because this demon is whispering sweet nothings that mean absolutely nothing to my destiny. I need somebody else in my ear, because I, Eve, in the beginning, I'm not strong enough to handle the sweet nothings that the enemy is whispering. She didn't know herself well enough to say, I can't handle this demon.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
I can't handle this spirit. Yes. She was insecure. She was prideful.
Yes.
So the enemy gives her something that looks good. Me.
Yes.
Come get your fruit, Eve.
Yes. Hallelujah.
The enemy. Jesus. Now stand right there in the middle. The enemy gives Eve something that looks so good to her. She sees the fruit. She understands the fruit looks good, but the Lord said, don't eat it, but it looks so good. And I see it in the natural, but in the supernatural, I'm missing something. I'm missing something.
Yes, yes.
She saw this fruit.
Hallelujah.
But she didn't know she was seeing her weakness.
Yes.
She saw this fruit, but she didn't know that it was wrapped up with insecurity. It was wrapped up with fear. It was wrapped up with doubt and hesitation. It was wrapped up with all kinds of stuff. It was wrapped up with fornication. It was wrapped up with lies. But you know what? I see the fruit. The fruit looks good to me. My attitude looks good to me, because at least I'm letting them know I ain't nothing to play with. So this fruit caught my attitude. But it looked good, God. It looked good. And it actually sounds good, because I'm letting them know that I'm the real deal. And if you don't come at me, I'm going to come at you hard. It's the fruit. It looks good and it sounds good, but underneath this, messing with my destiny. Underneath is messing with my destiny. Underneath is messing with my purpose. It's the fruit, though, but it's the fruit, God. It's the fruit. God, he looks so good to me. He looks so good to me. I look at the fruit, and I know he ain't in church like he's supposed to, but at least he come every now and then. But that fruit, it just looks so good. Can I just touch the fruit? Oh, yeah. Beer game. Yeah. Can I just touch the fruit? Can I just touch the fruit? God, I know you said Boaz was coming, but can I just touch the fruit? Oh, God, the fruit. But maybe when I marry him, it'll change. He gonna love God for real. I know he's playing with God right now, but when raped and molested, and but I trust the fruit of it. And then they can't see my insecurity. They can't see my fear. They can't see my brokenness. All the fruit I've been through, the process. The truth is, I still ain't over that divorce. But I'm gonna dress this fruit up.
Come on.
I'm gonna dress this fruit up. And they're gonna be like, oh, she got it together. Oh, she got it together. But in the town, this fruit's so rotten.
Yes, Lord.
This fruit is messing with my destiny. This fruit is messing with my breakthrough. I'll never see increase. If I keep eating on anger, I'm going to always be bitter.
That's right.
That's my fruit.
Yes.
But that's my fruit. But that's my fruit, God.
Jesus.
I keep eating on the painful yesterday. I keep eating on fears. I keep eating on bad relationships. I keep eating on not walking in my purpose. I keep eating on not loving myself enough. But that's my fruit.
Yes.
That's my fruit.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
The fruit looks good, but the root is of the devil.
Yes.
Glory to God.
See, you can't keep watering fruit.
Okay, now.
That the devil plants.
Yes.
Anybody got a boy body in your spirit? That when the devil gives you fruit that you ain't supposed to be watering, you got to give him a boy by.
Yes.
Ain't nobody got time to play with you no more.
Man.
I can't keep eating that fruit.
Yes, Lord.
I can't keep watering it. But listen, it's a real good point I want to make. The more that Eve watered the fruit, the more the fruit grows.
Yes.
The more she waters her insecurity, the more it grows.
Yes.
The more she waters her rejection, the more it grows.
Yes.
The more it just keeps growing. But that's her fruit.
Yes.
It's a fruit.
Yes.
She's running because she got shame. She's running because she got rejection. She's running because she got hurt. But listen, she's hiding behind her fruit.
Yes.
But this was the thing about Eve. Y'all check this out. When God began to walk, and he began to look for his beginning, he said, "Where are you?" And Eve heard God coming.
Yes.
And the same tree that she partook of, she grabbed the leaves of the tree that she took, and she tried to cover up her shame. She tried to cover up her guilt. She tried to cover up her brokenness. She tried to cover up her rejection. She took the same leaves from that fruit of the tree that she partook of, and thought the leaves would cover it up. One thing that I did, I researched leaves, and the word says that, as I began to study this, that people know trees, scientists, the people that study trees, they know trees by the leaves.
Yes.
So she didn't know that when God came looking for her and she had those leaves on her, he identified her by the leaves. Because what you gotta understand is the leaves produces the energy for the tree to grow the fruit. Come on, somebody. The leaves are producing the energy for the tree to even produce that kind of fruit.
Yes.
But you cover yourself in the same leaves that produce the fruit that you ate of. And you think nobody sees it.
Yes, Lord.
So you out of alignment with purpose. You out of alignment with destiny. You out of alignment with God's will because you got leaves that's covering up your fruit.
Yes, Lord.
But it look good, don't it?
Yes.
It feel good for a minute. And then when God comes looking for Eve, she's hiding behind the fruit. She's hiding in the house. She's hiding in the back of the church. She's hiding on her job. She's hiding in stagnation. She's hiding in procrastination. She's hiding in fear. She's hiding in low self-esteem. She's hiding in rejection. She's hiding in the hurt. Eve, where were you? God already knew where you were. He just wanted you to tell him. But Eve was too shameful to tell him. Oh, God, I'm hiding behind the same leaves that broke me. Hiding behind the same leaves that hurt me. I'm hiding behind the same leaves that rejected me. Where are you, Eve? I gotta hide behind the leaves. That's where I am. Because if I hide behind the leaves, I don't think you're smart enough to know it came from a certain kind of tree.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And then he said, where's the one that I called?
Yes, Lord.
To be an inspiration.
Yes, Lord.
Where is the one that I called to be confident?
Yes.
Where is the one that I called to be secure? Where is the one that I called to be in alignment with my word? Where is the one that I called to be in alignment with my will? Where are you, Eve?
Yes,
Lord. Yes. I don't know this person.
Yes.
I don't understand how she became who she is right now. Where is the Eve that I called to the forefront? Where is the Eve that I called to be a catalyst? Where is the Eve that I called to start the business? Where is the Eve that I called to write the book? Where is the Eve that I called to be a good mom and get out the She got lost in life. She got lost in the issues. Yes. She got lost in the tissues. Yes. She got lost in the... Where's the Eve that called to be in alignment? Yes. She, yes. She lost. Yes. She lost.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
She lost.
My Lord.
Yes, she Lord. Lost.
Yes,
Lord. She ran. Mm. She got lost.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Jesus.
It's time for you, Eve, to look at your dead fruit.
Yes, Lord.
And say, I don't want you no more.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
It's time for you to look at that dead position and say, I don't want you no more.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
It's time for you to look at the shame, the guilt, the resentment, the hurt, the pain, and say, I don't want you no more. And even when you at your lowest point,
Yea, though you walk.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Yea, though you walk through the valley or the shadow of death, you will fear no evil. Because he knew you was going to have a spirit of fear. He knew that the enemy was going to attack you. He knew the enemy was going to try to rob you of your peace. He said, yea, though you walk. Yea, though you going through this and that spirit of fear trying to come against you. He said, look, listen, Linda, I got you. Now, Mary had to take a look in the mirror. Y'all see that mirror?
Yes.
Mary had to look at something in the mirror to see that she was chosen.
Yes.
I'm about to close this thing out, but I want y'all to follow me on this last little bit.
Yes.
Mary had to look in the mirror to see that she was chosen.
Yes.
And 29. When the angel of God approached Mary, he called her blessed. Y'all walk with me for a second. He called her blessed. He called her favored among women. He also told her that God is with you.
Yes.
Now watch this. He said, Mary, you're blessed.
Yes.
Mary, you're highly
favored.
He said, Mary, God is with you.